ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासां ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नष्टप्रायेषु अपत्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 3 चैप्टर 25 द ग्लोरीज ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विस एंड टेक्स्ट नंबर 21। तितिक्ष्वाकारुणिका सुहृदा सर्वदेहिना अजातशत्रवः शान्तः साधवः साधुभूषणः। तितिक्ष्वः कारुणिकः सुहृदा सर्वदेहिनाम् अजातशत्रवः शान्तः साधवः साधुभूषणः। तितिक्ष्वाकारुणिकः सुहृदा सर्वदेहिनाम् अजातशत्रवः शान्तः साधवः साधुभूषणः। तितिक्ष्वः टॉलरेंट, कारुणिकाः मर्सीफुल, सुहृदः फ्रेंडली, सर्वदेहिनाम् टू ऑल लिविंग एंटिटीज, अजात शत्रुवः इनिमिकल टू नन, शांताः पीसफुल, साधवः अबाइडिंग बाय स्क्रिप्चर्स, साधु भूषणः adorned with the sublime characteristics. Translation and purport by His Loving Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. The symptoms of a sadhu are that he is a tolerant, merciful and friendly to all living entities. He has no enemies. He is peaceful. He abides by the scriptures and all these characteristics are sublime. Purport. A sadhu, as described above, is a devotee of the Lord. His concern, therefore, is to enlighten people in devotional service to the Lord. That is his mercy. He knows that without devotional service to the Lord, human life is spoiled. A devotee travels all over the country from door to door preaching, be Krishna conscious, be a devotee of Lord Krishna, don't spoil your life in a simply fulfilling your animal propensities. Human life is meant for sense self-realization or Krishna consciousness. These are the preachings of a sadhu. He is not satisfied with his own liberation. He always thinks about others. He is the most compassionate personality toward all the fallen souls. One of his qualifications, therefore, is Karunika, great mercy to the fallen souls. While engaged in a preaching work, he has to meet with so many opposing elements, and therefore the sadhu or devotee of the Lord has to be very tolerant. Someone may ill-treat him because the conditioned souls are not prepared to receive the transcendental knowledge of devotional service. They do not like it. That is their disease. The sadhu has the thankless task of impressing upon them the importance of devotional service. Sometimes devotees are personally attacked with violence. Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. Haridas Thakur was caned in 22 marketplaces. And Lord Chaitanya's principal assistant, Nityananda, was violently attacked by Jagai and Madhai. But still, they were tolerant because their mission was to deliver the fallen souls. One of the qualifications of a sadhu is that he is a very tolerant and is merciful to all fallen souls. He is merciful because he is the well-wisher of all living entities. He is not only a well-wisher of human society, but a well-wisher of animal society as well. It is said here, Sarva Dehinam, which indicates all living entities who have accepted material bodies. Not only does the human being have a material body, but other living entities such as cats and dogs also have a material bodies. The devotee of the Lord is merciful to everyone, the cats, dogs, trees, etc. He treats all living entities in such a way that they can ultimately get salvation from this material entanglement. Shivananda Sen, one of the disciples of Lord Chaitanya, gave liberation to a dog by treating the dog transcendentally. There are many instances where a dog got a salvation by association with a sadhu. Because a sadhu engages in the highest philanthropical activities for the benediction of all living entities. Yet, although sadhu is not inimical towards anyone, the world is no ungrateful. World is so ungrateful that even a sadhu has many enemies. What is the difference between an enemy and a friend? It is difference in behavior. A sadhu behaves with all conditioned souls for their ultimate relief from the material entanglement. Therefore, no one can be more friendly than a sadhu in relieving a conditioned soul. Sadhu is calm and he quietly and peacefully follows the principles of scriptures. A sadhu means one who follows the principles of scriptures and at the same time is a devotee of the Lord. One who actually follows the principles of scripture must be a devotee of God, because all the shastras instruct us to obey the orders of personality of a God. Sadhu therefore means a follower of a scriptural injunction and a devotee of the Lord. All these characteristics are prominent in devotee. A devotee develops all the good qualities of the demigods, whereas a non-devotee, even though academically qualified, has no actual good qualification or good characteristics according to the standards of a transcendental realization. ॐ अज्ञान निमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जना शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वप्रभुं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवान् च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगणरघुनाथन्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतम सावधूतम परिजन सहितम कृष्ण चैतन्य देवम श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगन ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितम तितिक्षवा कारुणिकः सुहृदः सर्वदेहिनाम् अजातशत्रवा शान्तः साधवा साधुभूषणः. The symptoms of a sadhu are that he is a tolerant, merciful, and friendly to all living entities. He has no enemies. He is peaceful. He abides by the scriptures, and all his characteristics are sublime. In the yesterday's purport, Prabhupada, he says, who is sadhu? A sadhu is not just an ordinary man with a saffron robe or long beard. A sadhu is described in Bhagavad Gita as one who unflinchingly engages in a devotional service. And the first line of this purport, Prabhupada says, a sadhu, as described above, is a devotee of the Lord. His concern, therefore, is to enlighten people in devotional service to the Lord. And that is his mercy. The first and foremost quality of sadhu has explained here as a titikshavaha, means tolerant. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord explains to Arjuna that he should tolerate the dualities of this material world. Because if someone wants to make a progress in spiritual life, he should not get affected by the modes of material nature and the reactions of our activities with the modes of material nature. And that's why Lord says that tam titikshvasa bharata, just tolerate, because that is the prime quality of devotee or sadhu. And what is the function or mission of sadhu? His mission is to enlighten the living entities to render devotional service to the Lord. And for that purpose, as Prabhupada explains, that the genuine sadhu, he goes out, he travels all over the world, and he requests everyone, Jaradeke Tarakah Krishna Upadesh. Whoever he sees, he tries to give them Krishna consciousness. As Mahaprabhu, he explained, Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur, you go out, go to each and every person in Navdeep and ask them to chant the holy name of their Lordship. Bolo Krishna, Kaho Krishna, Karo Krishna Shiksha. Please chant the holy name of Lord. Bolo Krishna. Kaho Krishna, Karo Krishna Shiksha. And practice the devotional service at his lotus feet. That is the mission of pure devotee or sadhu. And for that purpose, they are tolerating everything. Prabhupada has given few examples. The first and foremost example he gives, which is very suited for the people in the Western world who can understand that, Jesus Christ, when he started speaking about the kingdom of God, or the only about the God, forget about the kingdom of God, because that is beyond their perception. So they were not able to fathom what the wonderful thing that he is explaining. And rather than accepting him as a spiritual master, they crucified him. And at the last moment of his life, when he was on the cross, he was praying to the Lordship, "Oh my Lord, please forgive them. These people are ignorant. They don't know what they are doing." That is called as a tolerance. And that is his compassion also. Even though they are made all the attempts to kill him, they are behaving so inimically towards him, but still he was praying for them. Please save them. The same thing with Thakur Haridas. He was born in Mohammedan family, but he accepted Lord Krishna as the Supreme Personality of a Godhead and dedicated his whole life just to chant the holy name of Lord. And when the Nawab of Bengal came to know that this person is doing that, so he called him and he asked him that you don't chant the name of this Kafir people's God. But Haridas Thakur, he never agreed for that. He kept chanting. And that enraged the anger of king. And what he did? He ordered, beat him up and take him around the marketplace so that everyone should understand if they do chant the holy name of Lord, these are the consequences they are going to suffer for. So he was dragged into the 22 marketplaces. And the attendants of king, they were beat him up with a cane throughout the market. But he never gave up the chanting of God. Contrary, he was also praying for them. My Lord, they don't know what they are doing. Please take care of them. So here we can see their ultimate tolerance as well as their compassion. The person who has a tremendous tolerance, definitely he is going to adorn with the quality of compassion. Next example Prabhupada gives about Nityananda Prabhu. Who is Lord Nityananda? Who is none other than Sankarsana, Adishesha, who at the time of annihilation emanates the fire which can melt anything and everything in the universe. That same fiery personality, when he was carrying the order of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who is the most magnificent incarnation of the Lord, who has descended to this material world to preach the glories of the Lord. And when he personally orders his personal associates like Lord Nityananda and Lord and Haridas Thakur that you should go, Jara Deka Tara Kaha Krishna Upadesh. Whoever you see, just go and teach them about Krishna. And they did follow. And Nityananda Prabhu was so expert. He thought that going to each and every person, it's better to go to the most fallen person and change his heart. If we can able to change his heart, just by seeing the change of heart of that person, others who are favorable to Krishna consciousness will take Krishna consciousness seriously. So he did went to Jagai and Madai. They were the most abominable Brahmanas by birth. But due to the association, they became like a ferocious dacoits. They used to do all sorts of sins. They have not left any kind of sins that has mentioned in the scripture. But when Mahaprabhu went to them, saw him, by seeing him, they started teasing him, by mocking him, like Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. And they started dancing in their intoxicant stage, which they have got it because of excessive drinking. And one of them took the earthen pot in which he was carrying the liquor, and he banged on or smashed on the head of Nityananda Prabhu, and bleeding started. And as soon as that news went to Mahaprabhu, he came and he immediately asked for Sudarshan. And he wanted to kill them. But here, Madhavananda, he went and he hold the feet of Mahaprabhu and asked, please don't do that. Forgive us. And he said, don't ask me that. You go and get the forgiveness from Nityananda Prabhu. If he forgives you, I will grant you Krishna Prema. And same thing happened. Nityananda Prabhu, he never backed up. Because he was knowing the ultimate goal of life is to attain Krishna and to help other living entities. Preachers, they always take advantage of any time they get it and they preach. That is their mercy. So, Titikshava, Karunika, Surudha, they are friend to everyone. Not only human beings, even they are friends with animals. And again, Prabhupada quotes the example of Shivananda Sen, who was one of the richest person of Orissa. Since Raghunath Das Goswami has shifted to Vrindavan, about whom were we talking?
Shiva.
So whenever this Bengal devotees, they used to visit Jagannath Puri, Shivananda Sen used to take care of their finance. He used to provide them accommodation during the journey. He used to provide them food. So one time, one dog followed the devotees from Bengal to Jagannath Puri. And Shivananda Sen, he took care of that dog as he was taking care of other Vaishnavas. And ultimately that dog got his salvation. So whoever comes in contact with the sadhu and follows the instruction given by him, that person becomes eligible to attain liberation. So the devotees, they always compassionate to everyone. Then the next quality is Ajata Shatravaha. They don't have enemies. But this age of a Kali is exceptional. You will find more animosity towards the devotees only. Because the whole propaganda of this new era in this age of a Kali is just go for sense gratification. And devotees, they are going opposite to that. So they become, knowingly or unknowingly, enemies to so many people. Then further qualities are like Shanta is very peaceful. He never gets disturbed. He never creates any disturbance for others also. That's why he himself is a peaceful. And the next quality has explained Sadhava Bhushana, who has a sublime characteristics which are explained in the Vedic text. So whoever possesses all these qualities is considered as a sadhu. And whoever wants to go back home, back to Godhead, they have to become a sadhu. Otherwise, it's not possible to go back home, back to Godhead. And Prabhupada clearly says in the last para of this purport, a devotee develops all the good qualities of the demigods, whereas a non-devotee, even though academically qualified, has no actual good qualification or good characteristics according to the standard of transcendental realization. Hare Krishna. So, koi prashna ya koi tika tikni. Will happen if you start associating with the sadhu, because whom you associate, you become like that. Man is known by his own company. So if you have an association of sadhus, definitely. I got one nice, I will send you that, one audio clip from your Guru Maharaj. And he speaks about in the Grihastha Ashram, how one can achieve the perfection by taking association of sadhus. It's really wonderful. Okay, so we'll stop here. Grantharashrimad Bhagavatam ki. Srila Prabhupada ki. वही साधु है
साधु के बारे में साधु कैसे साधु हो तो कोई मतलब नहीं।